Shalom, Chevra. It's once again Erev Shabbos, it's Friday. Can't believe another week has gone by. And I'm hereby bringing you my weekly drush in preparation for Shabbos and as we end another week. And this is what I might have said at shul services tomorrow had we all met in person for a Shabbat service as we are accustomed to. So this week in the Torah, we have begun the fourth of the five books of the Torah, Bamidbar, which literally in Hebrew means in the desert. It's somewhat an enigmatic book to me. Let's review the five books quickly. So you have the first book of the Torah, Bereshit, literally in the beginning, in Latin, Genesis. That makes sense. It's the creation, according to the Torah, followed by the story, simply speaking, of our patriarchs and matriarchs. Second book of the Torah, Shmot, literally names, because it starts out with the names of Jacob and his descendants who went to Egypt. Exodus in Latin, it's the story of the Exodus, very simply speaking, and the receiving of the Ten Commandments, the Torah. Then we get the third book, which we just completed last Shabbos. Vayikra, God called out to Moses, literally, in Latin, very appropriately, Leviticus, because it's the laws, very intricate details of the building of the Mishkan, which is the predecessor of the current day shul or synagogue. Then we get Bamidbar, let's skip that for a moment, the fourth book, which we just began. Finally, the fifth book, Devarim, Ele HaDevarim. These are the words. That's Moses' ethical legacy, if you will, to the people of Israel before he prepares to go to his eternal reward. The book contains the Shema, the first paragraph of the Shema, amongst other things, a repetition of the Ten Commandments in a slightly different version. So those four books are very understandable. What's going on in them, what they are all about, which brings me to the enigma of Bamidbar, literally in the desert, Numbers in Latin, because it starts out with one of several censuses, counting of the people. So what is Bamidbar famous for? Well, it has the story, for example, of the rebellion of Korah. It has the story of the weird purification ceremony of the Parah Aduma, the red heifer. But nothing really jumps out at us by which we can summarize in one sentence, what is the fourth book of the Torah about? What is it telling us? Which leads me to conclude, friends, one thing. Bamidbar in Hebrew literally means in the desert. And frankly, in life today, as things are, we are all, the entire world, we are all in the desert. In the desert, there is a thirst, a longing for survival, for water, and water is life. We all are yearning to return to normalcy, and the world is slowly but surely reopening, as is the United States, as is Ohio. And the good thing that emerges out of the book of Bamidbar is from chapter 6, sentences 22 to 26. The beautiful, famous sentences, the Birkat Kohanim, the priestly benediction, which contains great hope, great beauty, talks about Ya'er Hashem Panav, that God should cause God's light to shine upon us during this very dark time. So that is my hope for you, for me, for all of us, for our beautiful congregation, for all our families, that we shall emerge from this darkness as we are already starting to do. And remember, the last sentence of that famous paragraph, sentence 27, says, "V'samu et shemi al bnei Israel, they shall place my name upon the people of Israel, and therefore, says God, v'ani avarechem, and I will bless them." As long as we act in a godly, in a divine manner, and imitate God's attributes, especially at a difficult time like this, what shall follow, I am confident, is a blessing from God. Shabbat shalom. I hope to see you all soon. Let's get